Here I'm asked to rationalize where I have a cubed root in the denominator. Now, before I do that, what I like to do is work with the prime factorizations of the coefficients. So 4 is 2 squared. Just makes my life a little easier in the end. So now, to rationalize this, I'm going to multiply by what I need to eliminate the radical in the denominator by bringing those exponents up to the index, in this case, 3. So I'm going to multiply by 2 to the 1 power, x squared, and a y. Whatever you multiply the denominator by, you also have to multiply the numerator by the exact same thing. This is so that you're really just multiplying the fraction by 1. Okay, in this particular case, I'm left with 1 times that cubed root, or just the cubed root of 2x squared y in the numerator. Now, in the denominator, when I multiply these together, you could see why I chose those powers. 2 squared times 2 is 2 to the third. X times x squared is x to the third. And y squared times y is y to the third. So notice in the denominator, I have a perfect cube. And then once I simplify, I will no longer have a radical in the denominator. So the cubed root of 2 cubed is 2, cubed root of x cubed is x, and the cubed root of y cubed is y. And that was the goal, to eliminate the radical in the denominator. So multiply by what you need to get all those powers up to the index, and then simplify.